Hi all, let's discuss some more JavaScript interview questions in this video. So I have taken few interview questions here. So my main aim is not to explain the particular question. So I'm trying to explain the main theme in these questions. So with this theme or with this concept, we need to answer a number of questions or we need to think in that way. So that's the main motto of explaining individual questions. So with this theme, we can answer a number of questions. So let's start here. So we have let new list and we have an array dot push. We are pushing 4. And now we are in the console, we are trying to push 5. So what would be the output here? So the intention of asking this question and will be what would be the answer? So mostly we'll be answering, we have an array and we will be pushing 4. And we have an array and we are pushing 5. So the tempting answer would be the A. So we'll go with the option A. But here we need to understand the point. Here we have an array and we are trying to push another element. So now what push is returning? Push will return the array length. So in this case, it will return 4 because we have 3 elements in an array and it is inserting 4th element, 4. So we have 4 elements in an array. The return value of push is the length of the array. So now in the new list, we'll be having 4. So 4 dot push, 4 is a number and push will work for arrays, not with numbers. So 4 dot push means it will, there would be a type error. The answer would be D, option D. So whenever are trying to answer this kind of questions, don't go to the quick option by seeing the push here. So remember what is returning. So the return values are more important for these type of questions. Okay. Coming to the second question. So we have an number, constant number, and we have assigned array with few elements. So what, and also the constant, and this is the, it was assigned to the numbers. What would be the console of y, just y? So we may think that we have a array in numbers and we are keeping the same in y. So we may go with the option B. But here the intention of asking this question is how far we know regarding ES6 array destructuring. So we may know about this. Let A comma B instance A comma B is equal to 1, 2. So we know this is an array destructuring. Here what happens? A is value is 1, B value is 2. So this is an array destructuring. The similar concept applies here. We have y here is equal to, we are giving entire array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are giving in this way. So what would be the value of y, the first element in an array? So y value is 1. So the answer for this question is C, 1. The intention of asking this question is how far we can apply the array destructuring for questions like this. So let's go to the third question. So this is, we have an object with A as key, 1, B as another value, and A with value 3. So we have 2 duplicate keys here. So the first question, we may go with the option of error, but there won't be any errors here. So we have A duplicate keys, 2 keys with the same name. What happens means in the same position, it will be like this. What prints in the output is the position doesn't changes, but the value in this will be replaced. So now the output would be this. There won't be 2 keys. This is the output. This key will be replaced with this key and the position won't change. The position would be left to the first part only. The value would be replaced with the second value, which was assigned. So there won't be any errors. So most tempting answer would be the errors in this case. So we need to understand that. So coming to the fourth question. So we have a function here. It is trying to return this dot string, str. So we have a variable, string is equal to global, and we have an object, string is object, assigning a string value here. we are calling a function here. So first, when I call this function, most of us would say this return undefined. This returns undefined because there is no this. I mean, there is no object here. So this dot string definitely returns undefined. But here the point is, we have a variable var string. So this is attached to the window object. So internally, it is this window global window dot string is equal to global. So internally, this is equal to this. And also here, this will represent the window. So that is the reason window dot str is equal to global. So now the first console will print as global. So that is the reason here the first console would be printing as a global. But the tempting value would be undefined here because we see there is no this here value. So obviously the second one is pretty much easy. We have a function and we are calling this function, same function, but this time we are passing an object. We are passing this object. So we are passing this object. So this dot string here represents object. So we'll get obj here. So that's the main point here we need to understand is whenever we have this type of conditions, don't just declare an answer here. Just think any variable which was declared like in a global scope, it would be attached to the window. And this here represents the window. That's the main point, key point we need to remember. So coming to the last question and very important question. So we have constant A, an object, constant B, another object with key value, and another constant C object with key value pair. So now here we are doing A and we are taking object B as a key of A and we are assigning some value. So what happens here? So before answering this question, we need to understand a core concept like in objects, object keys are automatically converted into strings. So this is the main one we need to understand, the main core point. It means any object, I mean, we have A is an object now. So B is a key for A, but B is an object here. So it is an entire object. So how it would be represented internally? It would be in this form. A of, so now we have wrote B, but B is an object. Object means it would represent like this, object of object. The key would be in this format, but it is converted into string. So it represents in this format. So now B would be looking like this because B is a key for A, whereas B is an object here. So that is the reason JavaScript engine internally converting this object as a key, as a string. So this is object we have and we are converting that object into a string. So that is the reason for this object we have a double quote and we are trying to assign 1, 2, 3 value for that. So the same happens to the second. C is also an object. So we are assigning this object. I mean, we are for object A, we are giving C as key. But here C is an object. So internally we have confirmed a point here. Object keys are automatically converted into strings. So the same happens here in this point as well. For C case also, it would be here. And now we'll be assigning 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 6 would be assigned in this point also. Now we are trying to console it. So in the console also, it would be the same. Last value was this one. So it would be there. I mean, it is taking this as a same value. We are assigned 1, 2, 3 to the same key. And we are assigned 4, 5, 6 also to the same key. And now we are trying to print it. So what would be the latest value in this object? So 4, 5, 6. So hope you understand this. So the main concept here is we need to understand the object keys are automatically converted into strings. So that is the reason a key of A is converted into string, but B is an object, so it was converted in this way. Similarly, C is also an object, so it was converted into the same way. So 1, 2, 3 is overridden with the latest value 4, 5, 6. And we are trying to print the same value, object of object. Then we got 4, 5, 6 is the answer. So hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching.